Good morning, good morning, good morning. Hey, Sister Beverly. Hey, Sister Arnaud. How are you guys doing on this morning? And I'm sorry I'm running a little bit behind. Hey, yesterday was a lot, but I'm trying to catch up on a little bit of rest this morning. Yes, yes. But we are here, and we still made it before 8 a.m. Listen, we are on day 14. Day 14. So if you don't mind, just like the video. If you can, share the video. You can share it afterwards. You can share it right now. And if, for those of you who watch us by YouTube, thank you so much for always sticking in there with us every day. Listen, we are on day 14. That means we only got 7 more days to go. And I'm actually starting to get a little tear right there. You know why? Because this has been an amazing experience with you guys. This is so much better than what we do at the first of the year. So I am loving the 21 days. Yes, I love the 21 days. And I hope you guys are enjoying it too. You can invite others to join us if you want to. And in a moment, I'm going to get started. I'm just going to share the video really quick, because I like to do exactly what I asked you guys to do. So I'm going to share the video. And then we're going to get started with day 14. But while we're doing it, I'm going to go ahead and let you know today is called Good Work. Good work. Good morning, LaShonda. How are you? You still hanging in there with us? Hey, I love it. I love it. Listen, day 14, good work. We're going to be reading Philippians 1 and 6 today. Yes. Man, that's a good scripture. Philippians 1 and 6 today. So I'm just going to go in here and share my video real quick. And then we're going to kick this thing off, okay? I have this other song I want to play this morning that I found. Because we talked about victory last night. Good morning, Sister Lisa. Good morning, Sister Ernette. How are you today, Mama E? We talked about victory on last night. This song says, we will fight. Remember, we talked about last night that God does not give us a yes, because he says, I need you to be able to put up a fight. And we're ready to put up a fight. Amen. So I'm going to go ahead and share. I'm sharing right now. And then we're going to go ahead and get started. This is day 14. Day 14. Good work. Amen. Good work. We're overcomers by the blood of the Lamb. Amen. So good work. Day 14. Y'all ready? Hey, Tasha. How are you doing on this morning? Let's see who else is watching. Ernie, hey, Mama E, I'm going to say it again. Hey, how you doing? Sister Beverly, how you doing? Sister Lisa. Keisha Maxwell, girl, how you doing on this morning? We got LaShonda Crane in the building on this morning. Yes. Sister Terilyn Arnaud is in here on this morning. Thank you, ladies, for joining us on this morning. And for those of you who watch us by YouTube every day, I thank you guys for joining us on the 21-day journey. Listen, we are on day 14, and today is called Good Work. Good work. I want you to put that in the comments for me. Good work. Good morning, Heather. How are you on this morning? Good work. Listen, Heather has become an honorary member of the 9. I'm telling you, she is on with us every time we go live. So today, we're going to be reading from Philippians 1 and 6. But before we get started, I just got to remind you of a couple things here. Listen, we got to still continue to build our faith, y'all. We got to still keep working on building our faith. No matter how bad you feel or discouraged, you know, you still have to understand that God is behind you. He's pushing you. I mean, that's a daily reminder for myself. Like, I'm telling you, when I told you last night, the enemy, me and him are in the ring right now. Yes, we are. And I have to remind myself every day that God has my back. He is pushing me. He is pushing you. And guess what? We are going to get through this. We know he's mad because he don't like this 21 days. All right, but also God's power is limitless. It is. It's limitless. There is no limit. A couple days we said, stop putting limits on God. Why? Because he's limitless. Don't put him in the box. Don't put yourself in the box. don't put limits on yourself, because God can give us the power to be limitless as well, but we have to ask him that in faith. So let's go ahead and get started today, because we're going to be talking about good work. Philippians 1 and 6, and I'm reading from the New International Version. It says, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. I'm going to read that one more time for you. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Listen, being confident, that's some strong language right there, right? He started off saying, be confident. And basically what that means is to be fully and firmly persuaded or convinced. So here Paul was entirely convinced of the truth in what he said. It is the language of a man who had no doubt on the subject. Paul goes on to say that he who began the work. In other words, Paul is making it plain to us this morning, ladies, and he's making it very clear to us that the work began with who? It begins with God. It begins with God. There is no reason why he should begin such a work and then abandon it. God abandons nothing that he undertakes. Oh, I love that. God abandons nothing that he undertakes. It says there is no reason why he should begin such a work and then abandon it. He abandons nothing that he undertakes. Today, I want you to know that if you feel like quitting, if you feel like giving up or letting go, keep holding on. If you're going to keep holding on, I want you to put that in the comments for me on this morning. I'm going to keep holding on. We're going to keep holding on, y'all, because God is making it clear for us on today that he is the one who started the work. He's the one who started the work, and you better believe he is the one who is going to finish it. All right, so it says again, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion. So he's going to finish this thing until the day of Christ Jesus, okay? So I'm going to read this to you really quick, and then I'm going to post this on our page. So this is something that we should be mindful of. It says, he will complete it. God will complete it. I'm going to change he to God. God will perfect it. God will perform it. God will accomplish it. God will not let it go unfinished. He will not let it go undone. He will not let it go incomplete. Why? Because he will finish the work. He will complete it. So with that in mind on today, I want you to make this your good work day. This one braid is killing me. I want you to make this your good work day, because God wants to remind you that since he started the work in you, he's going to be the one to finish the work. He's going to be the one who finished the work. So you ain't got no problems. You don't have to worry about anything, because he doesn't have a problem finishing it. It says again that he will complete it. He will perfect it. He will perform it. He will accomplish it for you. He will not let it go unfinished. He will not let it get undone. He will not let it go incomplete, because he will finish it. And now is not the time for us to start backing down, ladies. It is not the time for us to back down. It's not even the time for us to start second guessing God. It says in his word, being confident, because we know that anything that he starts, he finishes. The good work that was started in you can only be completed by you. So be a big girl on today and get the job done. And put on your Nikes and what? Just do it. Just do it. So go ahead and get the job done, because God says it's going to be completed. He's going to be right there behind you, pushing you, moving you forward. Because anything he starts never gets undone. He doesn't abandon anything. So on today, I want you to make this a good work day. A good work day. So your reflection moment for today, no matter how bad you feel or discouraged you might be today, God is behind you. He's pushing you, and you will get through this. So I want you to reflect on, what is it that motivates you to get going? What motivates you to get going? What is it that you can think of that says, hey, Hey, Steph. Hey, Beverly. Hey, Heather. Hey, LaShonda. Hey, Lisa. You got this. You got to keep going. What is your motivation? What is that thing that pushes you, that keeps you to keep going? And I want you to reflect on that today. So when you take that moment to go into your prayer closet on today, I want you to make sure you acknowledge who your source is and acknowledge that He is our provider. He is our healer. He is our redeemer. He is our deliverer. And thank Him. Thank Him in advance for what He's doing, what He has done, and what He is about to do in our lives. Okay? So make this a good work day. Whatever it is, don't worry about it. God says we are going to finish it. God says we are going to finish it because He doesn't abandon anything that He starts. So you guys be blessed on today. I can't wait to join you on tomorrow for day 15. But listen up. Tonight at 7 p.m., our very own Pastor Carter is going to be teaching live in 45 Bible study. And y'all already know how it goes up every Wednesday. So join us tonight online at 7 p.m. for live in 45 Bible study. And guess what? I'll see you back here tomorrow for day 15. And I'll give you the words for day 15. Watch out. It's going to be a good one, okay? Day 15, I'm going to bring on a special guest with me on tomorrow to help us with this journal on tomorrow. So I'll see you tomorrow. And don't forget, make it a good work day. Think about what motivates you. And you get in there and you get the job done because God says, I got your back. I got your back. You guys be blessed. I love each and every one of you. Make it a good work day.